Boston Hollywood Show FUI Report Special for the spring quarter 2019. And we have come to the segment that you FUIs love the most. I've become over the years, know you love this segment the most, never your FUIs. It's the email segment. And for the email segment, I'm talking to the man, Hollywood Alex, lay out for you what you hear over the next 45 minutes to an hour of emails, and what can you can expect to hear the next 45 minutes from the listeners who send in their ridiculous, goofy-ass emails for us to read over there once every quarter. Hollywood, it's on you, my brother.
This is the most ridiculous crap I've ever seen. We're live. Okay. Yeah, these are some, this is crazy, but this is what we do, so here it goes. All right, this is our first listener email. Bilal and Squeaky Knot.
Oh, Lord.
I would like to enlist in the Salvation Army. I wish you all could see how this stuff is typed. I would like to enlist, not enlist, enlist, in the Salvation Army. How do I enlist in the Salvation Army? Are you aware of the Juarez. Are you aware of the Juarez that the Salvation Army is fighting? Much love, Malik Murray at Exxon and Suburbs. Well, I don't know about the Juarez that the Salvation Army is fighting, but I know you need a whore with school or hooked on phonics. You need to go to war with that.
That's terrible. Like, really, the whores? I mean, like, my man, it's a simple word, wars, but you call it the whores. Really?
He needs to go to war with a dictionary.
Oh, God. That's terrible.
Yeah, that's absolutely preposterous. What the bloody hell? That is the worst. Well, I'm gonna attempt to answer his question. Okay. No, we don't know of the Juarez that the Salvation Army is fighting. Okay. We don't know how you enlist into the Salvation Army. You understand? The Salvation Army is not that type of army. The Salvation Army is the type of army that battles homeless.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Or, you know, they battle, I guess they battle not having
poverty. They battle poverty. They battle stereotypes against people who don't have that much to poor. They're about the poor and the needy. They're not about fighting a war, unless you're talking about the war against poverty. Yes, but that could be a war as they're fighting, but not the war you're talking about. And you don't quote enlist, you volunteer, my man. You don't enlist,
right? You fill out the paper like an application.
How does one get to that point that that's even a thought in their mind?
Like, you don't enlist. Your ignorance is endless. Your FUI-ism is absolutely endless. There's no end. It goes on forever. All right.
Oh, God.
Gain my composure back. So, here's another idiot. All right. Okay. He starts off teeth. I have issues that they can fix. I have, oh my God, cavities. I guess he's trying to say cavities. I have cavities. I need feelings in my teeth. please assist me, Nick from Dayton, you imbecile. First of all, I don't know why you're talking about teeth. I don't know why you're talking about cavities. And yes, you already have feelings in your teeth, you idiot. I'm not going to assist you with anything, you goofball.
Like, why do you say it to us? Like, that's not something we can help you with, brother. That's goo.
Or yeah. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know why. Ding that. Anyway, okay. Next one. Excuse me. Listener email. Aspen and Randall Target.
What?
Jesus.
This is already bad. I have moved to a new city.
Wow.
Is this the same thing? I have issues with my teeth.
God. Back to back. Like, are you kidding me, Nick?
Do you know of any dentists in my area that can fix my, and didn't even finish? He probably passed out. You gotta be drunk to write some stupid crap.
Oh, God! Oh, Jesus. Really? Look how you spell Dennis's, though. That's terrible.
Right, he spelled it like a name. Denise's.
Wow. Nick is terrible.
I mean, why? Anyway, I'm not going there. They're not going to. The FUIs are not going to press my. You're not going to press my buttons. I'm going to keep my calm until I read the next one. All right. Here we go. Check-in in South X.
Wow.
That fool said check-in. There's a growing issues with these females walking around with booties of concern.
Wow.
What?
These are the booties that are oddly configured and flat in nature. Okay. The looks of the booties of certain clan, what? Really rubs me the wrong way. The figures are pathetic. Bad booties are bad for proper eyesight production.
What? What does that even mean?
Proper eyesight production? So he's producing eyesight?
Dude, what?
And it's not like sight, like as in sight, G-H, you know what I'm saying, G-H-T. It's S-I-T-E, it's a plate.
Dude.
A setting. Proper eyesight. So he's in the business of producing where your eye is at on your head.
Look how he spelled fur. Like, he's like, we put fur. Like, not four, but fur. Like a fur coat.
Man, oh, man. How can we form a coalition of proper figures, enthusiasts, to shut down the booties, shut the booties of concern, little booty matter movement?
What?
With the platform. Oh, my God. The plaque form that you have, we can sync up to overtake them and shut them down. Evan at Best Buy.
Really, Evan?
First of all, before I even say anything, let me spell plaque form out for you out there. PLAQUEFORM. Not platform. Plaque form.
Terrible.
Okay. Now, let me address this, okay? Whatever type of booties that you're talking about, you know, that doesn't even, this is just really stupid. Like, why are you even writing us talking about booties of con. He said booties of concern.
Like that, so I never heard of that before. Booties of concern. Like, what is that?
Like, right.
BOC. We have BOC issues. Like, not some politicians are like, yeah, booties of concern. We got to make sure we get those in check. We have to pass a bill to help those booties of concern. So it's like a political thing, like a political statement or some kind of term of
right.
Use. Like, really?
Booties of concern. Look, we're not using our platform for that. We use our platform to expose people like you.
Exactly.
You're the talk of the day. And this is the perfect example why. Does that answer your question? Evan at Best Buy, who should not quit his day job.
You know he should.
He's sick. This dude is even sicker. I don't even know what the hell this is. Listener email. Jeremiah Ramon in McGain.
What?
Meganique Wise. Where did that come from? Like, where did you get that?
Exactly.
Oh, this is gonna be good here. I would start with here.
Oh God, that first line would make her go crazy.
I wish Star was here. I can hear her right now. Like, this is stupid. Verily, 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 I say unto you, I come in peace. I am man. What? Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am man, coming off of a negative experience with thine ex.
Oh Lord.
Thine ex that I loved and cared for. Verily, verily, I say unto you, I need you counsel in how to progress. Verily, verily, I say unto you, thou lovest her and thou missest her. Verily, verily, I say unto you, this is the quandary.
Oh,
thou meetest woman at the job receptacle. The job receptacle? The princess and I formeth a bond over processes and deplorable behavior at the dungeon of healthcare, and we maketh our weekly coin or shilling. Over time, we formeth a bond you after the connection. It commenced an official declaration of connectivity. Thou began on a journey of love in which thou thinkest that we were on a that leadeth what? That leadeth to a connection between the princess and I, in which I place thine sexual instruments in her sexual reception compartment.
Wow.
All right. Verily, verily, I say unto pathway to marriage, thou had issues with thine princess after it was unearthed, that thine princess still harboring feelings for former prince. Verily, verily, I say unto you, this broadest issue between me and thine princess, relations has not been the same. Thou hast hurt in thine heart and soul. What can thou do in the interim and in the future? All I can advise
jump in the ocean,
Johnny,
please.
All I can advise to this idiot is to stop reading so much Shakespeare.
Oh, God. Sean would go crazy if she heard this email.
And this is not anybody named Johnny, man. This is Rob Zombie.
Has to be.
This is Zombie, dude. Like, really.
Because why would that come into us like this? I said, what? I saw the emails like, this can't be real.
It's real. Yeah, this is the voice of reason type. I'm the voice of reason.
Yeah, that sucker is dirty as hell for that email.
Yeah, dude. Because, and it's long too. So, dude, you are an FUI of the highest caliber. As a matter of fact, I'm going to go on edge and I'm going to say that this is the most FUI email I think I have ever read.
That's horrible. This email is terrible.
It is beyond. This is just jacked up. Oh, wow. Like, I gotta get my bearings back after that one. Like, I'm speechless. Like,
We thought we got rid of that kind of emails and talk to us, but no.
Oh my God, dude. Like, all I'm thinking about right now is Ascot's umbrella, flip flops, and purple shorts.
In church.
Behind the organ.
Wow. Char and Woody would be going crazy right now.
They'd have been like, man, you can't be serious. Shut the whole damn show down. Just forget it. This is a state of emergency.
Oh my God, that was terrible.
That was absolutely deplorable on every level. I can almost imagine it's going to get better. All right, man. That was heavy. Like, that was heavy.
Very.
Man. Okay. All right. Listener email. Timu Dreyer.
Wow.
Man. Okay. I was rocking with a shorty that I truly like. Hey!
That's a good starting off. Yeah.
That was just the first sentence. Like, and I lit up. Like, for real? I can actually read it. Okay. She really wasn't my type physically. She was 5'4", 304 pounds, I guess. Well-proportioned, top and bottom, nothing out of frame. But she was cool as hell. We hit it off over venting to each other about our relationships. I ultimately was willing to work with her. Okay, whatever. She was smuggling to shake over her ex.
Smuggling? Oh, God.
Man. What a disappointment. She was smuggling to shake over her ex, which created tensions between us.
Tensions? Oh, God.
If it created tensions between y'all, what's the problem?
Exactly.
Somebody getting paid. Anyway. All right. She said she loved me. I said I love her. I truly love her to agree with a solo session with me. What? Agree to it. What? Okay. We did the business.
Oh, no.
That led to more days and nights together. Okay. Ultimately, we got into a relationship. It was good. I delegate me your thoughts. Man, Dwayne that Dylan.
Wow. That was all over the place.
Then it says after. Oh, man. It says after. Her, she thought me to love big proportions women. I put my best in her and bailed, claiming she need to woke on herself. Now my 18-month pursuit is all for naught. Man, when you work at Dillard's, I mean, it was all right at first, man, and then he started going all illiterate on me.
Quickly.
Talking about, I guess he got into a relationship with some thick chick, you know what I'm saying? Peace on my BBW. And up until the smuggling shake over ex, like, I was lost.
That was like, at least, really, dude.
Well, I mean, we know that, you know, it created pensions between them. Pensions, like,
not tensions, yeah, but pensions.
intentions.
Smuggling, not struggling, but smuggling.
Yeah, they need to, I mean, they're getting their pensions. Maybe they can retire. We're going to retire this email that we just got, too. Dwayne at Dillard.
Dillard, some all
he
places.
Saw me to love big proportions women. Man. You know what he sounds like? You know what that sounds like?
What's that?
Have you ever gotten one of those emails that tell you that you've, like, won, like, $500,000?
Yes,
and it's from the right. And it's from, like, the Cotonou, Benin.
Yes.
Like, somewhere in Africa or something.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of what that sounds like.
Terrible, Dwayne.
You just know that it just reeks of fraud. Yeah. Whatever. All right, moving on. Listener email. Oh my God. Elite Mustard in Magaloo Trigonese.
Jesus.
Man, I'm done. I meet M-E-A-T.
Wow.
I meet this 48-year-old Wayman that works at Uvert. Not a woman. A Wayman. I thought he was talking about an old magician. Like a shaman or something. Anyway, she a manager at Uverse. Man. We begin noting each other daily.
He put delay with two Y's.
Oh my God. We can to a point to score conversion in bedroom. Oh, God. I was pounding that Wayman. We take a trip to baseball game. Man, excuse me. Making me choke. We take a trip to baseball game. She was make noise about the seats and how much I paid for seats. Shouldn't she be happy at trip and be at game? At not sweeting me over how much I pay for seats. I feel she uncompreciative of me and my gesture of nignness.
God.
I stopped peeking to her. Was this the right move? Jaron Michaels in Charleston.
Wow.
It would be the right move if you learn how to read and how to type correctly.
That would be the right move, yes.
Because I don't even know what the bloody hell you're even talking about. And if I don't know what you're talking about, I can't answer your little stupid little mealy mouth questions. You know, so yeah, we're going to move on. Sorry, Kat. Sorry, Jaron. You're an idiot. Peace. All right. Dude, please don't set me up. This is a setup.
It looks good, though.
It's a setup. It's gotta be. When was the last time that somebody actually got our name?
Never.
Do you remember?
I can't recall.
It's probably happened. I just don't remember it. So something tells me either, you know, we're gonna get zapped or read it anyway. Okay? I want y'all to listen up real carefully. Somebody's about to take me out my character. Alright. Listener email, Boss in Hollywood.
Amen, about time.
Alright. Look, brother. I recently had a bad experience with a young lady that met at church. I thought was cool, humble, young lady. Okay. We had 5 days of great conversation covering a multitude of topics. All right. Just for information's sake, she's 37, a MUA. I'm 40, a car salesman. She's got one son.
What?
She's got one son, theater to see a couple of well-known comedians. Okay. I hit her up, my typical good morning text, and adding in the ask of date and letting her know what I have special needs and I have no kids.
What?
Yeah, you do have special needs. I thought you were just... After our 5 days of conversation, I felt things were going in the right direction. I decided to buy tickets to the comedy, did. Okay, gotcha. Her response was, sounds nice, but I've already been there 3 times this year. All I said was, gotcha, and I never hit back again. I feel like this it's a comedy theater. You might have been there 3 times this year, but you saw a different act. So I'm shut down because where previous men took you and it didn't work out. She reached out and called me fake, petty, and snakish. How am I those for deciding to move on for her BS? Reggie. Wow. Wasn't bad. I mean, it wasn't good. It wasn't bad.
Bad.
Okay. Maybe you can elaborate on that a little bit, boss man. I'm gonna sum that up.
Yeah, Reggie. So basically, what you're saying is you and chick met at church. So y'all hit it off pretty well. You want to take her today to the comedy theater. She said she been there 3 times this year. You got mad because you feel like it's different accent with the comedy show. She's been with other guys that didn't work out. She shut you down too. Well, I think. In that regard, Hollywood, I would put my foot down and move on, too, because if I'm trying to take you out on a date to a comedy theater, yeah, you might be at the time, but you are seeing different acts. I agree with him in that regard. And First of all, you just accept the date. It's a comedy show. He's trying to take you. You're having a great time on the phone. But if he lets her dictate to him the date terms that early, he'll never have another date again. She'll say, we're going here, and he'll be a sucker. So I feel he had to put his foot down and move on to keep any integrity that he has, But to me, it was the right move. She should have just been cool about it because it was a comic. That was like Chili's or something like that, or some old Charlie's or something. I get that. Now I would be like, okay, let's go somewhere different. But a comedy theater, said a different comedian, I can't go with that. So yeah, I'm good with him moving on for her.
Yeah, I can definitely dig that. I could care less if you went to the comedy club to see Earthquake last month. Okay, if we're going back to the comedy club to see Chris Tucker, and I think that's, you know, coming off of that, I think that's going to be a good date, and that's where I'm taking you. Shouldn't you just be grateful that I'm taking you?
Exactly.
We're going out on a date, you understand? And if you didn't have any input, you know, when I told you we were going to the comedy club, don't be salty about it now. Because, of course, you had to know beforehand. Because a good guy is going to prepare for a date. And I can only speak for myself, you know what I'm saying? I always, when I went on a date, I always planned my dates out. I planned them out. You understand? And I would expect that women would expect that from a man. It's for the man to plan out the date. And the objective is for the woman to just relax and not have to worry about anything but enjoying the date. Her objective is to get done up, to go through her day, to have a good day getting done up, pedicure, manicure, whatever she does, getting her hair did, this, that, and the third, finding the outfit, whatever she wants to do, but I'm going to plan the date. You understand what I'm saying?
And you're going to pay for it.
And I'm going to pay for it, of course. Because that's me. And I would think that that's any respectable young man, you know what I'm saying, to pay for the date. You know what I'm saying? You're not a sucker because... because you want to be a gentleman. You understand? But at the same
time, he will be a sucker. He will be a sucker if she planned a date in here to pay what she planned. That would be a
right.
sucker move.
Right yes.
there. And that's what he's trying to avoid, I think.
Right. And you mean to tell me you're going to air out on me because you've been to the comedy club a bunch of times? What if I had never been?
Exactly.
I mean, it's still a date, right? We're still going to go eat. We're still going to do this, that, and the third. And he's absolutely correct. You understand? You may have went to see thus and so back in the game at the comedy club. But of course, with every comedian, you understand, is a different personality. Therefore, they're going to bring a different vibe of funniness to that comedy club. You understand? You're not going to always see the same people doing their routine at the same comedy club. You know what I'm saying? So in my opinion, she should be grateful, you know, that he actually planned out the date. And it could be a good date if she just plays her position correctly.
Exactly.
But she did not. So now you done turned that cat off and he's just like, man, you know what I'm saying? I just planned a date to go to the comedy club. You know what I'm saying? And we going to eat and we going to laugh and it's whatever. And now you done ruined that. That's a red flag. So, now I got to go. And I'm with him. Yep. I'm with him. So, Reggie, even though you're a dingbat, you know, you sent the email, you know, and even though it was much better than a lot of the emails that we've seen, you're still an FUI. You're still a dingbat. So, there you have it. All right. Here we go. Leonard in Darryl, Kentucky. Okay.
Jesus.
Oh, man. This is going to be good. I met this damn near 50 broad on the date app. First mistake. Me and Shorty vibe good. Vibe so good that on day two, outing one, we hit the sports bar and I take her back to the spot and beat her aged, ancient box up, dropping all the
what?
Dropping all the cream in her. You. What? UANLAN? What is this dumb crap? We. Man, I can't read it. Gonna try and repeatate that predicament to his box. She actually come see her at night Walmart job. I did on tree Austin.
Jesus.
Set up future dates. Plans fill through. Okay. I got frustrated with her. Well, you know what? I'm getting frustrated with you. Okay. I spoke my mind. She say the first night didn't have happened. And she wasn't going to let it happen again. And that she just wanted to be friends. I see FUB. I see FUB and hung up. Just BF up. Mario from Jungle of Chicago. Man, you're making my city look bad.
Very much so.
Like, you're an idiot. Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm going to side with the chick on this one. And it's not for the reason that people, that you might think. It's just because I'm siding with her because she had enough brains in her head to say that she just wanted to be friends. That's it. She wants to be friends.
He couldn't take no more of that. He said, "No, I'm not." He's thinking, "I'm going from the box zone to being a friend zone. I'm out." Get frustrated, old Mario. But at least she was honest with him. You know,
he's a dingbat. Dude, really? You just threw this predicament.
Yeah, that is terrible.
Whatever, man. Okay.
Repediate.
Wait a minute. Where's that at?
Before predicament. Predicament.
Repetition. That's what that fool said.
Terrible.
Yes, horrible. Anyway, yeah, but congratulations to the chick, though. Because you ain't going to be able to communicate if you can't understand what the hell he's saying. I'm pretty sure he talks like this. Huh?
He probably does. You're correct.
Yes, I'm pretty sure. All right. Here we go. Lawrence in Hollywood.
Really?
Lawrence? Anyway, okay. Lawrence in Hollywood. I think this sucker foul. Old chick I talked to that worked at the hospital. We met when I went to visit a sick family member. We hit it off before hitting happy hours. Here and there, you dig? Chick said she wants to go on a weekend excursion conversion. Shoot, I was down with that. But damn, the vibe was smothered. Smoother. The vibe was smoother. And shot when she said, we ain't having no relation. She said that we be in separate rooms. So she wants me to pay for a trip in separate hotel rooms. Treat and I get no love. Hell no. Nah. I kick it to the curb and said, I ain't no sucker. I'm doing all that and I get no payoff. What's the word, brother? Talk to me, Bankhead in Dallas.
Pretty good email considering all things. Pretty good email considering all things.
Woo! I would have still. If you're a real player, you could still go. You know what I'm saying? And if she ain't trying to, you know, I'm just telling you what I'd probably do. I mean, I'd still go. And, you know, I'd be doing me. You can go in your little separate room, you know what I'm saying? And I'm going to do me, and you're going to hate yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Because, yeah. I mean, I'm not going to stop my good time because, you know. I mean, but that's all you. You know what I'm saying? They're friends, apparently. You know? They said they've been kind of hitting it off, but I mean, that's not promising anything. You know what I'm saying? Because with me, you know, in my experience, we are not together until there's some type of verbal agreement between both of us.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? We're not together. We're single until we can get these terms of agreement together. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if I'm going on this this excursion conversion, as he says, you know what I'm saying? And she switches the lane. I mean, it's not going to be any sweat off my back. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a player about mine. You know what I'm saying? So don't be looking goofy. You know what I'm saying? If, you know, we go out and kick it and somebody's filling me out, it's going to be what it's going to be. It could have been you. But, you know, that's not what you wanted. So I'm going to respect that, and you respect me.
Amen to that.
I mean, it is what it is. This is a friendship. You know what I'm saying? I just got a chick. You know, I dig her, of course. We like each other. But, you know, for right now, this seems like friend zone stuff. You know what I'm saying? There ain't no verbal agreements. We're not talking about no committed relationship. I didn't hear none of that. I just heard hit it off. Cats hit it off with chicks every day. That don't mean they gonna get the draw.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So that's what I would do. But, you know, it is what it is. What's your take, man?
I'm thinking my man he should have played it out. Saw what happened. But he pulled out quick. I can't fault him, though. He didn't want to put no effort into it, spend no money. He wasn't guaranteed. So I get that aspect of it too. But I'm like, yeah, I would play it out and see what I could pull it off. Cause I have confidence in myself to pull something off.
That's what I'm saying.
I would have rolled the dice, maybe.
Right. That monkey ain't gonna stop no show. You know what I'm saying? Now, you know, I'm not gonna, if I'm really going on the trip, we going on a trip together as friends, I'm not gonna pull myself out because, you know, you don't wanna make a move, or it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna force, I ain't forcing nobody to do nothing, and I ain't tripping over nothing. We're out here to have a good time. So if having a good time consists of me meeting somebody, you know, out here while we kicking it and we really hit it off and we do whatever, that ain't none of your business. You gonna know about it. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is until you make a move. Until there's that communication. Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Tonight, that's what's up. Or we really kicking it like that. Or there's some kind of vibe like that. You understand that we both picking up on, like, yeah, this is what we going to do. But I guess she had already made it established that it wasn't going to be nothing. Right?
I think it was spooked. She put it out there already. And he wasn't willing to test it.
That's what I'm saying.
Because I feel like if we're out here together, we're out of a different town together, me and you, all you got is me. So right. You really going to not give it to me if I make the right move? I feel like he had advantages to test her theory, but he didn't do it. He didn't want to spend that money because it wasn't guaranteed.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Now, the thing is that could go, I mean, it could go either way. But the thing is I'm not going to sell myself short by saying screw it. I'm going to go have fun. You know what I'm saying? Because anything could happen. You know what I'm saying? And if that don't happen, I'm going to make something happen. You know what I'm saying? I can make something shake. You know? To where even if she don't make a move, you're still going to be winning. But, you know. Just saying.
Now, Hollywood, we're up against the break here, so we're going to save that last email for segment three. We got up against the break here, people. This was the main email segment. We got one more to go. Next segment, we'll do this email, then we'll start off with a whole sit down with the material for you and say, this is going to be a longer break than last break, okay? It'll be double the break we had the previous segment, so we'll be back double the time we was away last segment, so stick with some live stream. I appreciate all you guys checking us out here at live stream and BossManShow.com. This is the email segment. We got one bonus one in segment three after the break. Boss of Hollywood, stick with us here on the Boss Man Show, Boss Radio Network, people, live stream. We out. And if you don't know, now you know.